Today, I'm going to go over all of the positives and negatives of playing Outriders on the Xbox Game Pass, and we're going to start right now. What's up, guys? Reckless here. Welcome back to another video. Warning, this video contains spoilers that are not shown in the Outriders demo. So, if you don't want spoilers, please leave this video now. You have 5 seconds. You have been warned. Before we actually get into the video, if I sound a lot better and clearer, that is because I actually upgraded my mic from a condenser mic to a shotgun mic, and it sounds so crisp. I love it. And I just wanted everyone to know that we are currently having a giveaway for 3 full versions of Outriders, and it will be the digital versions, of course. And details for the giveaway will be towards the end of the video. Now, let me be clear about this video, and it is strictly my opinion, and I am not biased one way or the other. I am just looking at the bigger picture from an early millennial perspective that was raised by Generation X parents. So, let's get into the video. A few days ago, on March 15th, 2021, it was announced that Outriders will be coming to the Xbox Game Pass on the release day for Outriders, which is April 1st, 2021. And I will start off by saying that is amazing. I love what People Can Fly and Square Enix are doing for this game. They are literally making this game available for almost all of the platforms, which to include Xbox One, Xbox Series X, Xbox Game Pass users, PS4, PS5, Steam, Google Stadia, and with free upgrades from previous gen consoles to current gen. I say almost because Nintendo still isn't quite there when it comes to violent games, and I'm pretty sure they won't be for a long time. With the Xbox Game Pass, you can even play Outriders on an Android phone and tablets via the Xbox Cloud Gaming Service, which is actually in beta at the moment, but only on their Ultimate subscription. If you don't know, the Xbox Game Pass is a subscription platform that allows you to play hundreds of Xbox games for a very low price. As of this video, here are the current pricings for the Xbox Game Pass. And feel free to pause the video to get a better look at what you can actually get for what price point. But I will be moving on. As I said earlier in the video, there are positives and negatives to Outriders coming to Xbox Game Pass. And in no particular order, I will be going over them. Positive: you don't have to buy Outriders because as of April 1st, and this is not an April Fool's joke, you can play Outriders for a low monthly price. Negative: by not pre-ordering Outriders, you won't be able to get the Hell's Rangers content pack. If you don't know what that is, I will put an annotation at the top right of the screen now and at the end of this video. Positive: you may still be able to get the Hell's Rangers content pack in the future when it's released to everyone. Possibly, but that's not a given. Negative: you're not really supporting the developers and publishers by playing Outriders on the Game Pass. Remember, the only way they actually get paid is if we buy the game. And it is the same concept with your favorite music artist. They don't get paid if you use a service versus buying their album outright. Another negative, and this one is kind of like a double whammy. If by some reason the Xbox Game Pass's servers go down and you can't download the game for an update, or you don't have the money to re-up on your subscription, you can't play the game. Negative: what if the contract between Xbox and Square Enix expires and the deal isn't good enough for them to renew the contract? Well, what happens then? Outriders gets removed from the Game Pass and you will have to buy it anyway in order to play again. Positive: at least Outriders will be tied to your Microsoft account, so you will still have all of your game save files. Positive: besides Outriders, you can also get hundreds of other games to play. But keep in mind what I said about game updates, as well as renewing your subscription. Now, I am sure that there are tons more positive than negatives to why the Xbox Game Pass is a good or bad idea for the community. But I just wanted to hit on the most important things when it comes to the Xbox Game Pass coming to Outriders. One thing you can say is that it won't happen, or they wouldn't do that, because nothing is actually guaranteed when it comes to the world of businesses and contracts. There are tons of what-if scenarios that can play out in a matter of months. Remember, Outriders was made to be a full game experience, not a service with subscriptions or microtransactions, which is why People Can't Fly, who are the developers of Outriders, didn't make this game with that type of model. And also, why the game is getting such great reviews and only the demo has been released. Personally, when I buy a game, it's an investment. Therefore, I like owning the game that I buy, and I will always buy a disc version of the game if I can. I don't know, I'm old school like that. One thing I will say is that I am not a financial advisor. In the end, it is your decision on what you want to do, but I will tell you to go ahead and weigh out the options. I am not here to tell you what you can and cannot buy, or what to buy, and how to go about spending your money. Let me know down in the comment section below whether you think that Outriders coming to the Xbox Game Pass is a positive or a negative thing. Because I definitely want to hear your guys' opinions on everything as well. So, you made it this far into the video and you want to know about the details of the Outriders giveaway. Well, it's very simple. All you have to do is follow me on Twitter and put your platform of choice in the hashtag giveaway section of the Everything Outriders Discord. That is all. You don't even have to subscribe to my YouTube channel in order to participate in this giveaway. I will let you do that on your own. But if you did subscribe, then the support is greatly appreciated. The giveaway will be going from March 17th, 2021 to March 31st, 2021 at 6 p.m. EST. A link to my Twitter and the Discord are in the description box below. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. And I will see you in the next one.